You have a tendency, curiosity to know about others and to know about others' personal life. That is the reason so much these yellow magazines are getting sold. Yellow magazine means the magazine which writes about others' personal life, others' sex life or the violent life. The crime magazines and the sex magazines, why they are getting so much sold? Because you feel so tasty when you know somebody else's personal life. I have seen many people asking our organizers what Swami is doing in the morning time, where he is going, what he is going to do, what he will be doing in the evening. I mean, what you have got to do? He will be there surely in the evening program, public function. For public satsang, he will be there. You come, that's enough. But they are not happy. They are not satisfied. They ask, here Swami wears the wooden sandal. I saw in LA, he was wearing the wooden, the plastic chappal. What all he wears? What all he uses? So much curiosity. With me itself, so much means with you all, how much they are doing. Because no way I am related to them. With me itself, they want to know so many other things. You see, many people I have seen, nobody wanted to know how he became enlightened, how I can become enlightened, I can also become enlightened, or how he can help me, or how I can also be helped by him. That nobody wants. What he wears. And I have seen many people asking, does any Swami looks so nice. Is he using any costumes? Is he using any oil for his hair? What type of powder he is using? See, it's just a curiosity. Am I right? People ask all these things. First thing, I never use anything that is different. Now, the curiosity of the people. We are so curious to know about everyone's life. We'll be just sitting and collecting materials to go and talk outside. If you do that, you are disturbing the benefit of others. Please be very clear. Now, just for these 2 days, take an oath. I will not go and talk outside what I heard from others. It is a promise you are giving to keep others' privacy. You see, if you don't take the promise, if you are not ready to take up that promise, I am not going to lose anything. You are going to lose. It is each one of you who are going to lose. So now you need a social commitment to have the maximum from me, to have the best out of this class. Please be very clear, to have the maximum from the ASP, if you are prepared, that is enough alone. But to have the maximum from NSP, the whole group needs to be prepared. That is why I avoided the people who have not done ASP. If you have done already, you know what is to be with the master. What is to be by the word meditation means. If you have not done, understand. If you feel you can't understand, leave the hall. That's the best thing. But be very clear. You need to respect the privacy of others. Each one has got their own thing to speak, their own thing to ask, their own thing to tell. First thing, don't carry tales. Don't carry tales. It's a very sincere guidance from my side. One more thing, when I say how the course is going to be, I myself do not know. I mean, I know the whole thing. What is going to happen, I know. But how much you are going to use it, I do not know. It is in your hands. If the whole group cooperates, only then the next technique will be more deeper. It's like a traveling in the deep forest. It is going to be more like a traveling in the deep forest. See, the whole ASP was more like a plane. The NSP is more going to be like a traveling in the deep forest. Of course, your eyes will be tied. You will be blindfolded. What is the way, best way to travel in the forest if your eyes are blindfolded? Hold the hands of Master. Then you will see, you will be able to use totally, you will be able to have the maximum benefit. So just put your whole effort, understand, here we are on the journey. That's what they call the mystery work. It is going to be more like a mystery work. And every meditation, everyone is going to have a touch. You understand? In every meditation, I'm going to come around everybody, come here everybody. Don't think it's not like a mass sermon, ASP. ASP, any thousand can attend. Any number of thousands can attend. But this is not going to be like a ASP. If you have the benefit, you have. If you don't. That's the ASP. But here, everyone I'm going to attend. Everyone I'm going to come near. On every meditation technique. Not on only one technique. On every meditation technique, I'm just going to be around you. You are going to relate with me. It's more or less like an operation. One thing, if you have only an intellectual relationship with me, please leave the hall. If you really have a heartfelt relationship with me, then only you can be here. In ASP, I ask the people to question. They can question me. They can crisscross me. But here, it is totally going to be not the relationship of logic or intellect. It is more going to be like a feeling of love. You are just going to travel in the path holding my hands. It needs love and the tremendous trust. It needs a tremendous trust and love. Not simple intellectual relationship. There are people, you see, I always tell in my discourses, don't have faith in me, just doubt as much as possible. Carry on your doubt, then the doubt will guide you. These are all only for the people who have done the first level. Only for the people of ASP. Now, you need to put your whole effort and you need to just travel with me. Totally. Layer by layer. Step by step. Unless you travel, you see. Unless I feel satisfied the whole group is entering into the meditation, naturally I will be stuck. Or I will not be able to lead the whole group into the next meditation. I don't want the group to suffer just because of one or two persons. Just because of one or two persons, the group cannot suffer. It's going to be more like a journey. I wanted everyone to taste the spirituality, glimpse of the God in a solid way. It's going to be more like a deal. Either have experience or refund. It's going to be more like American deal. Yes, money back guarantee. You see, I'll be spending my whole life and energy telling them, hey, close your eyes and meditate. After 10 hours of meditation, they'll be just sitting and watching the others. 10 hours of discourse, they'll be just sitting and watching the others. I wanted at least few group who are courageous to have the taste of reality. You see, to have the taste of spirituality, you need courage. I tell you, to enjoy the bliss, you need courage, actually. Because the bliss does so much for you, you are just taken. You are just flowing. To flow, you need courage. Actually, to stand in the ground, you don't need courage. But to jump in the water and to flow with the water, you need courage. It's going to be more like a jumping inside and flowing. Just floating. So I want only the people who are really courageous, who can put their effort into the meditation. Not Oh, I had a good weekend. Let me go and spend with Swami. So be very clear. Of course, it is going to be a very great experience, but which needs a lot of courage, which needs to put your effort, which needs to be. The whole process is going to be about relaxation. That is why you need to put your effort. Because you have forgotten the way to relax. These 2 days is going to be totally relaxation. Because you have forgotten what is relaxation, you need to put your effort. We will have the oath. You all will close your eyes. Let me finish the thing. Close your eyes and take the oath consciously. You see, it is a commitment, promise to the energy. You will not go and talk outside after these 2 days about the personal life of everyone, because there will be so many who will be expressing their questions, their lives, their miseries or their problems. They will be asking. It is not going to be like an ASP, the mass program. I am going to relate with every one of you. Individually. So many will be asking their personal things. So if you try to go and express outside, you are just doing Guru Droga. Understand? It's a Guru Droga. It's going to be just cheating or exploiting the trust of the other. So never go and speak outside about others' problems or others' words. Because everyone has got their own life. Who are we to judge or to comment? Next thing, don't judge somebody. Never judge. Are you here to give judgment? Are you here to give a judgment? Are you here to judge somebody? If you are, please leave the hall. Here nobody is there to judge others. Each one has come grow themselves. To expand in their own way, to have the taste of spirituality, to have some benefit in their life. Each one has got their own reason for being here. So never judge others' reasons. Never judge others' life. Never judge other beings. Be very clear. Take a strong, conscious decision. You will not go and speak outside about others' life. You will not, same way, have it in your mind and behave with them. Not only you will not speak. One more thing, if you know something of their life, then after going outside, oh, this guy, I know about him. And you will be thinking, that foolish guy expressed all his life. He spoke about all his personal life. I'm so intelligent, I never spoke anything. I was just as I am. I behaved very gentleman way. Be very clear, you are the worst fool. It is a beautiful opportunity to open yourself, to open your Pandora box, to open your being. When you open here, the master will be here to clean. The master's energy is here. It can clean you up. If you feel you are very intelligent by not opening up, be very clear, you missed the great chance or the possibility of opening. I have seen many people. He had somehow an affair, extra affair. Of course, he was courageous enough to tell others, that's all. He was having a deep guilt for it. Deep guilt? Because of that. Finally, a time came, because of that guilt, not only he dropped the affair, he was not able to mentally drop. He has dropped the affair physically, but mentally he was not able to drop. It was just like a heavy thing on his mind. He says, in the morning till night, day in and day out, my being is just being suppressed. I'm feeling suffocated. I'm feeling heaviness. when he came and spoke to me about this problem, he just told everything in a patient way. I listened in a detailed way. And then finally, just I put the hand on his head, told him, "Don't worry, it is healed. You will not have any more guilt. That's all, nothing else." Of course, after a month, when I saw him, I saw what has happened. Your face has changed totally. Your eyes have become alive, living. He said, "Swamiji, I do not know what has happened, but one thing I am sure, I have totally forgotten the very root of the guilt. The very root of the guilt has disappeared." When you open the layers of your mind, layers of your being, energy directly enters. See, as long as you keep it closed, you keep it locked, the energy never penetrates. When you open, the energy totally penetrates it. Energy is being flooded. Originally, the confession technique, it's a technique. The confession in Christianity is designed based on this philosophy only. Of course, when you confess to the masters, that is, you will be healed. Ordinary confessions are not going to help you. In the master's presence, whenever you open something, it is totally washed and cleansed. It is totally purified. And not only master purifies it, you yourself will know what was happening inside. Only when you verbalize. Only when you bring it out. So, please understand, not only you will not speak outside, ill are the things which are expressed here. You will not have the prejudice or a wrong opinion about them. You should not form your own opinion about them, what you are listening from here. So never judge others. Stop the idea of judging others. You are not common civilians. Understand, you are seekers. I don't want civilians here. I don't want anybody who is living in the society here. I want only seekers who are ready to commit and give preference to the spiritual growth. I want here only the people who are ready to taste meditation, who are ready to taste the spiritual life. That is why I made lot of rules, lot of filtering before entering here itself. This is not the open invitation. ASP is an open invitation. You can say, "Then why did you invite me?" Here, it is not open invitation. It's only for the chosen few. So now I tell you, you are going to travel a journey which is really going to be beautiful, which is going to be full of flowers. I don't want any thorns. If you are a thorn, you will be disturbing others. So just become a flower or escape from here. So I tell you, put your whole effort. Don't have anything, any trace or hangover of the society. In the outside world, you may be a person with a sharp tongue, talking about others. That may be your hobby. But here, at least these 2 days, never do that. And one more thing, outside, whatever way you may have been relating with each other, you may be friends, or you may be enemies, you may be husband, wife, you may be son and father, you might have had any relationship. Now, in this hall, please keep all your relationship outside. Here, just be individuals. All your relationships, just drop outside. In the path of spirituality, you cannot travel together. It is a... The breadth of the path is only 1 feet. Only one man can travel. It is always individuals who traveled and experienced. Even in the case of Ramakrishna and Sharada Devi, they both have become enlightened, but only individually, not together. So, the spiritual path is only for individuals. Now for these 2 days, be totally an individual, physically and mentally. Now for these 2 days, you are individual.